بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم السلام عليكم Today's our video is about sovereignty حاکمیت I am Ubaidullah, student of finance and economics Here is the definition of sovereignty which I have downloaded from Britannica Encyclopedia In political theory, the ultimate overseer or authority in decision-making process of the state and in the maintenance of order. The concept of sovereignty, one of the most controversial ideas in political science and international law, is closely related to the difficult concept of state and government and of independence and democracy. So, however, its application and practice often has departed from this traditional meaning. It was just a definition derived from internet, from Britannica Encyclopedia. Now, a teacher in Islamic studies, Dr. Muqaddasullah, he was once a teacher with us, explained to me the origin of sovereignty by giving the following example. Once a small child, now an electrical engineer, noted his mother pressing a button on the wall and amazed to see how instantly the nearby bulb started emitting light. He thought to himself that the power must be in this button. He was then a child. He thought to himself that the power must be in this button. He insisted to his mother to pick him in her arms as he wanted to repeat the experiment himself. As time passed, he grew up. Now, he is aware of electrical cable in his home, connected to an electricity distribution system, which itself is connected to a production facility called, for example, Tarbela Dam, located in Sawabi district of Khyber Pakhtunkhwa province, producing an invisible power called electricity. Further, he knows that the dam is built on River Indus and stores large amount of water. This water, which is with its huge power, flows through turbines which generates electricity. Further, he knows the water in River Indus comes from the snow capes on mountains in northern colder parts of Pakistan. Rain and snowfall from clouds in sky is a frequent phenomenon in these parts of Pakistan. But where does the cloud comes from? Clearly, seawater when heated with heat contained in sun rays is converted to vapors that become clouds in sky. Finally, who controls the sun which provides us so much heat? This is specifically the question raised by Prophet Ibrahim before the King Nimrud of Babylon. And the answer clearly is no one but Allah. Allah controls the sun. Hence, we conclude that the light in a bulb originates from a treasure owned and controlled by Allah. Nature, in fact, is a treasure owned and controlled by Allah. Nature, which the natural resources which we refer to in economics are in fact nothing, but they are triers of Allah. Finally, therefore, we conclude that Allah Himself is sovereign. Allah Himself is sovereign. Allah is the origin of sovereignty found in some members of human society. Look, how fortunate we Pakistanis are. We have got the objective resolution in our constitution which clearly states that sovereignty belongs to Allah. Sovereignty belongs to Allah. Now, let's see how an individual becomes sovereign. An individual who, number one, believes in Allah, number two, can effectively control himself, is educated and knows how to control himself, third, knows how to minimize his need, number four, knows how to fulfill most of his needs directly from nature. Five, can produce goods or services then can be marketed. And number six, knows how to trade in market and has got a positive balance and is a sovereign individual. He actually has got hasana. This word appear in our mission statement. He has actually got hasana or true money. And what is this true money? The goods and services supplied to the market for trade. This supply is actual money. Such a person almost always have a positive balance in his account. And it is very difficult to impose something on such an individual. He is a king in himself. Now, how a community becomes sovereign? A community, number one, consisting mostly of sovereign individuals, as defined above, with capabilities different from one another. Number two, willing to help each other by producing and trading needed goods and services. Number three, regulated by community agreed principles. Number four, through a community currency as medium of trade. Number five, having mostly a positive balance in its account. Here I mean by the community have a positive balance, or in the community itself has a positive balance in its account. Teaching skills to its unskilled members and transferring capabilities to other members. Number seven, acquiring new skills as needed by community. And number eight, headed by an agreed representative from themselves, is a sovereign community. Such community can help itself in most of the cases. Further, it can concentrate, it can counter trade its extra goods and services with other communities to get goods or services which, for whatever reason, it cannot produce. You may like to extend this idea to a sovereign city, a sovereign district, a sovereign province, or even a country. The basics discussed here remains the same. Please remember that a community is sovereign because it has many skilled people with different capabilities ready to help themselves and one another. It is not because of money, it is because of these skilled people. Skilled people are the pride of a community. Money, on the other hand, is just an artificially created artificially created token to support exchange. To support exchange, not rule exchange. Communities, if needed, may develop their own money by the following by following the material freely shared on this channel. Communities, if needed, may develop their own money by following the material freely shared on this channel. Please remember, we need a supply-centered economy instead of the conventional money-centered economy. At work in this channel, we insist on supply-centered economy. The present, we are against the conventional money-centered economy. At work, this is our way to self-determination, self-sufficiency at grassroots level and sovereignty of mankind. Thank you for being with us. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.